Monte Carlo simulation. It's a special type of simulation which is built on a statistical technique which help us in generating various possible outcomes with the help of thousands of random variables and help us in doing risk assessment and financial forecast. This particular technique we can use as a quantitative risk assessment. From an exam perspective, understanding this much is good enough that yes, it's a special technique which requires generation of random variables. Now, for a little bit more understanding, I am giving an example. Assuming I am doing a project planning with the three activities and I want to identify the optimistic, pessimistic, and most likely outcome for these three activities. For simplicity's sake, I am using simple numbers. So assuming all these three activities can be optimistically can be done in a 1-1 days, and there is a sequence. The most likely time is a 2-2-2 days, and maybe a pessimistic time 4-4-4 days. Yeah. So now if I have this data and these activities are expected to be done in a sequence, I understand the optimistic time for my project is 3 days, all three activities happening in 1-1 days. The most likely time is 6 days, 2-2-2, and the pessimistic time is 12 days, 4-4-4. Yeah, that's the information I have. Now, if my manager comes and asks me that I understand optimistically you can finish this project in 3 days and pessimistically you can finish in 12 days, what is the likelihood of this project getting done in less than 8 days? Give me a percentage forecast for less than 8 days for this particular project. Now, how possibly we can generate that data? Here, the Monte Carlo simulation can play a role. So what Monte Carlo simulation will do, it will create, say, 10,000 records under these range, which may be showing one scenario, first activity took 1 day, second activity took 2 days, and third activity took 3 days, yeah, like that. So they will, for the same three activities, under the boundary of 1 to 4 only, it will create a lot of randomized possible situation. And based on those possible situations, we can identify, say, out of the overall 10,000 records, how many of them are coming less than 8. And by doing that, we can calculate the percentage and we can say that probability of this project finishing in less than 8 days is X. This is how Monte Carlo simulation works. This explanation is just for making your understanding. From exam perspective, it is good enough to remember it's a quantitative risk assessment technique.